Good morning, everyone. I have a feeling it is going to be one of those mornings. Good morning, good morning. It is Thursday morning and I don't even know what the date is. I thought I'd be really smart and come in and tell you what the date was so that you knew when this streamed live, but I think it's the 9th. I'm not 100% sure. It's just one of those things. My name is Alisa Tilsner. I am a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator in Australia and I go live every Thursday morning this time, which is 10 a.m. for me. And we do some live card making. So each week I focus on a different bundle or a suite. And this week we are looking at the Festive and Fun stamp set, which is a standalone. And I've teamed it up with the Merry Bold and Bright Designer Series paper because that it would be a fun match. So that's what we're going to be looking at today. So I'm going to colour the mousse. I haven't coloured the mousse yet, so I'm feeling I want to colour the mousse. And I'm thinking a lot of circles in my card as well. Sort of got a little bit going on. So welcome. Good morning, Deborah. Good morning, good morning. It has been I know it's only 10 a.m., but I tell you what, I have had a morning already. So, but I will talk about that as we get moving. So let me switch my camera around. So this is the Festive and Fun stamp set that we are going to be playing with. Hello, Leanne. So we're going to be playing with this one and I will give you a little tip. So if you are, because we are going to be doing some colouring in, just real quick basic colouring in, but if you happen to be on a stream on Facebook and YouTube at the same time, if you're on YouTube and you're on a mobile device, you can actually pinch your screen and zoom in so you'll be able to get up real close to my colouring for that. So I am going to pull out the good old Stamparatus. You may have a different platform, but I want a nice bold black image for this one. So let's get it inked up. And I thought I did re-ink my Memento not long ago, and I'm just, sorry, tapping that off to the screen over there. I did ink up my Memento not long ago, but, you know, I can never tell how it's going to be. I need one of those door handle things with the felt on it. That's what I need. I asked my son to 3D print me one, you know, and of course, because I'm family, I don't get anything done, do I? I showed him a picture of one and everything. I'm sure he could come up with it. It's probably just easier for me to go and buy a door handle, right? Okay, so I've got my nice big black image and I will grab him out. Oh, so how's everyone's week been? Is it good? I hope you're, I'm gonna. They are strong. I only ever use one at a time, but gosh, they're strong. Okay, I'm gonna put that on the floor, where it belongs. Okay, let's get some colouring in. So we've got our mousse and I smudged. Ugh, typical, just as well. I'm going to cut him out anyway, so that's okay. So again, if you are on YouTube, you can zoom right in. Oh, there we go. Now, I don't know why it does that. Why do you do that? Come back to that screen. Okay, so I'm going to start off with my crumb cake. I think I'm going to do his body in the crumb cake and his and antlers and his hooves and everything in pecan pie. Now, I don't eat Christmas pudding. So this guy's got, it's got some, is that icing or something on top of the Christmas pudding? What color do I do? Is it white? What color do I do that? So let me know. Let me know as you're coming in, what color do I put the pudding in? Because I do not eat it. All right, going to start off. I'm going to use my bullet tip because he's a little bit small. So I'm just going to go around the edges and I'm going to have my light direction come from the left. So I'll put some darker colors on the, oh, I nearly did his jacket then. I'm just going to put darker color on the right hand side, the opposite, just for a little bit of shadowing. And then I'm going to do a little bit of shadowing underneath his jumper there, and his tail can just be the one color. So good morning, good morning. Oh, my day already has been it was going well. And then I released my next colouring class this morning, and it was going all really nice and well. And then someone messaged me and said, there's no link in the class PDF. And I was like, oh no. So I had to go and rearrange that and get the correct link happening and email everybody who'd already managed to purchase it in the, 10 minutes that it was live. So, oh gosh. So Deborah said her week has been really productive. She wishes the weather would make up its mind. I know it's warm, it's cold, it's, and you get all the seasons in one day, don't you? It's ridiculous. So I'm going to come in with a little bit more. I'm going to double color this one. So I'm going to bring in dark again. And I find that the light crumb cake wants to eat out the dark crumb cake with this one. It must have a lot more solvent in it. So it always wants to eat out the darker colors. And I don't want it to. So that's why I come back in sometimes with my dark and just add a little bit more, because I don't want that happening. So I'm going to try and stay away. And if you now I'm getting a harsh line. So I don't know whether you can see, I'm going to bring that up to the camera. So now you can see I'm getting a harsh line because this light one wants to, or I call it eating out, wants to get rid of that dark color. So I will come, and then if you keep going over it too much, you end up with a hard line, which I don't like either. So just going to come in with my dark again. And what I do when this happens is that I just dot, because then I can just put on a really tiny amount. So I just dot some of that dark back in. And that way it doesn't leave me with that harsh line. I'll bring that up again. Have I been getting the storms? No, I haven't. We've been missing out. No storms here. And no, there's been promise of rain and we haven't had any. I saw that there was supposed to be rain, coming, and of course our area was completely dry. Other parts of the state will probably get rain. But and then I heard something on the news. I was in a different room and I heard on the news last night something about being 37, and I was like, what? That's crazy. Storms last night for Deborah. Crazy. Okay, so I'm going to use pecan pie for his thingies here. That's not really a good word, is it? His thingies. His antlers. Goodness me. Oh, and now it's doing it again. Why am I... Now, hopefully I'm still with you guys because my screen keeps going black. And I don't know whether that's because I'm having internet issues or not, but I'm just going to do a little bit of his hooves under there. Okay. So again, if you're watching on Facebook, you might want to race over to YouTube, because then you can zoom in on this coloring and you won't have to wait for me to bring it up to the screen. Right, a little bit on these thingies, his hooves. So what color do it now? Again, I probably may not have heard. What color icing do I do? Do I just do white icing? I come in with my dark again, just to add in those darker bits again. Just bring them back. And I don't think I have to do too much with these little feet and these hands. Okay, I'll bring that up to the screen. Lots of storms in Melbourne and Victoria. No, we have missed it all over here. Okay, I'm going to do, now the red is actually Poppy Parade. So we're going to do Poppy Parade for our jumper, sweater, if you're an American. Okay, dark. And just going to bring that around the back area, keeping all my dark on the right-hand side. A little bit around there, a little bit under his arm, a little bit in front of his arm. Oops, he's got another arm over there. Don't miss that one. A little bit under the collar. And you know what? I'm just going to do his jumper all in red. So, and I'll do a little bit under where his neck would be there as well. Still you good. I don't know why it keeps blacking out. Okay, and then we're just going to fill in. Like I said, this is just really, really simple coloring. Nothing fancy today. I did a lot of coloring yesterday, so I don't know. Can you get too colored out? I don't know. Okay, and then I'm going to come back in with my dark one again and just add those darker areas in there again. So I'm just going around the edges there. I shouldn't really do that. Okay, oops, and we've got some holly going on, so we'll put... Oh, we've got a plate there too. What am I going to do with the plate? And some green leaves. Don't use that end. Okay. So we have had online exclusives released this week. And, it's been big. Okay, so I've got some other stuff to show you too. So remind me of that. I get sidetracked and I think I... focusing on my colouring to start with. So I'm going to put a little bit of Flirty Flamingo in his ears because that's always cute. And I think I might just put crumb cake as the plate there. I know this is a lot of brown, but that's okay. And I think I'll just do pecan pie for this pudding as well. So just... dark underneath where that icing falls. That icing can just stay white. Assuming it's icing and it wouldn't be custard because that'd make a mess everywhere. Alright. Okay, I think I'm going to say that's it with my blends. So there he is, like so. And now I am going to bring in my pencils. And look what I did. I went through, I found a colour chart and I put them all in pretty order. Look at that. And then with my bigger pack, it looks even prettier. Oh, I won't show you that. That's okay. So I'm just going to grab my black and my white out. So if you caught my colouring yesterday in the Blends and Beyond group, I actually coloured one of these images the same way, but I coloured him on yellow, light yellow, lemon lolly. So I'm just going to add some black around the right hand side. I'll just do a little bit in there as well. So if you are watching, hey Tanya, if you're watching on, I'm just going to say it again, if you're watching on Facebook, you might want to race over and watch on YouTube because you can zoom in if you are on a mobile device. I'm just going to add some dark on the side of him. And you see how that automatically makes it look like there's more light coming from this side because he's darker on this side now. It looks like he's got a lot more light shining on him. And just down the side of his leg. And that leg. Do his little tail. I'll just do a tiny little bit right underneath his jumper there. And maybe a little bit under this jumper. And I think that's it. You don't need a huge amount of darkness on him. I might just, nope. Put it down and then I might be able to just bring in a little bit of light on this side of him. A little bit on his face. I should put a little bit of blush on his cheeks too, hey. A little bit on his I keep going to call him antennas, antlers. Goodness me. Antlers, not antennas. That would indicate he would be a Martian. He is not a Martian. Okay, so I'm going to bring in, I've got a pink here, which is a really nice blush colour. And I'm just going to put a little bit extra in his ears. And then I might just do a tiny little blush on his cheek. Just because he is on the cute side. He can be blushing, can't he? All right. Maybe I've made him too feminine now. Huh. So that is him done. There we go. So you can see I've got a little bit of highlights. You can see the white picking up in his antlers, and I've got a little bit of white on his jumper, a little bit dark on his jumper, just to really add a bit more depth to the colouring. So if you haven't tried adding coloured pencils before, just start off with black and white and see how you go adding in those little bits of extra colours. Now, I do have to fussy cut him. I apologise. But what I can do in the meantime is come over here and let you look at this guy here, because he is the guy I have, and I keep going round and round and round in circles trying to find a place to start. Does anybody else do that when they cut things out? This is the little guy that I have released this morning. So I filmed him in big, it was a massive file. It was like 17 gigabyte or something. It took, embarrassed to say, it took about 10 hours to upload yesterday with my super slow internet. But I think it was about 4 hours of processing after that. But he is up and he is ready. I had a little bit of a hiccup. So if you haven't got the link in your PDF, I've had a few people purchase already, although I did try and send them out straight away. But that is all up and running now. So this is a fur technique. So I did use the Fluffiest Friends, but you can use any of your stamp sets that have fur on them, you can use. So if you've got dogs or cats or anything like that, you can, this is more of a technique. So it's just the one image that I've colored for it, and the video is just under an hour. So there's hopefully a lot of good information in there for you to be able to do that. Okay, we'll come back to me, get rid of you, hide. Okay, good. And then Michelle was the one who said, Alisa, there's no link in your PDF. And I was like, and then I thought I'd fixed it, and then I put the wrong link in there. And then I had to refix it again. But, you know, we got there in the end. And then I looked at the time and I was like, oh no, I gotta go live. What am I gonna make? What are we gonna make today? So, anyway. It's all good. It's all good. Oh, I was still managing to have a cup of tea while I was doing it all. It is okay. All right. So let's get. And that Blends and Beyond group that I have, it is growing, 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 growing. So, okay. There we go. Nice, nice, nice. Okay, so I am thinking circles. I have got white cardstock here. Oops, oh my goodness. All sorted. Sewing and watch me. Ooh, are you sewing something new, or are you doing I was gonna say repairs. It's not repairs. What do you call it? Alterations. All right, I'm thinking I'm going to put a base of fa-la-la-la-la, because I quite like that. And I reckon I don't. That's the piece that I've got. So I was thinking I might do him. I've got my sentiment, which I might stamp and cut out with another die. So let's do that, just so I know where I am. And then I thought to have perhaps him on a coloured background circle, and then two little other circles. So it'll be four circles, but I will be having five elements. Michelle says alterations, because she's got to play for more blends. I'm hearing you. So I was thinking I could do a circle from that, and also a circle from that one. What do we think? And then maybe, I don't know what color circle to pop him on. So I will leave that for a moment and let's get all our other bits and pieces and elements together. Just so I know what we're doing. Okay, and I think, will I do a border? I think I will, because there's probably going to be a lot of color in this. So I've been quite liking cutting my designer series paper so it covers my entire card base, but I think I will just have a little bit of a border with that one. What's on the other side of that? Circles. So I think I'll have, oh, keeps going black on me. Thank goodness it's only for a second. So, oh, that is a really tight border. Do I have to? Oh, that's because I did a 16th. Oh, I don't work in 16ths. What's my brain doing? So I'm thinking something like that. And then, oh, I can put you away because you are a lot of color. Hey, Wendy, haven't seen you for a bit. Okay, so I've got my circle dies here. And I'm going to find one to cut this one out. So I think it may, nope, you're too big. And you just fit. Good, good. What color should I put him in on front of? Good morning, Michelle. Hello, everyone coming in. Okay. So let's get this out. Any ideas on what color I should put him on? Maybe pale blue, which is pool party. Maybe that would be a good one. Or the green, because I've got... Let me grab some cardstock and we can decide what colour, because I'm probably going to need to... Nope, you're too big. I sort of want him... I didn't want him to be on the whole circle. I wanted him to sort of stand. He might have to be on the whole circle. So... might have to do a bigger circle... Didn't really want to. Okay, let me get some. Deborah says pool party. Let me get some pool party and let me get some, what did I say? Green, which actually the green might be a little bit too green. He might be a little bit too. I reckon the pool party too, Deborah. Let me just grab a piece. A scrap down here. Would that be big enough? Probably not. Ooh, yep, that's gonna be. Yep, that's it. Just nice and soft, not too bright and leery. All right, let's cut that shape out, because then I'm also gonna cut out a circle from the stripe and also from the star. And I'm thinking I'm gonna just tuck them behind these other two circles. It's in my mind, don't worry. At least I hope it's might be in my mind, but it might not translate. sometimes my brain and my eyes don't what I think what I want to happen and what actually happens doesn't actually happen. So I was thinking something like that. And then I was thinking, oops, and then I was thinking just some other little circles. Like coming around. Actually, I might only need one. I might only need one extra circle just to come around here, because I was going to have one come down here and then one down there, but it might be too much. But you know what? I can always not use, but I think I will need to use small circles. So little ones. So let me try the yellow one. What do you think? That one makes him pop out? Yeah, I think that one looks a lot better. I think the green sort of, because it's lemon lime twist, I think, well, I could have done granny apple green to match the green in the holly, but that's okay. So I thought about putting a star there. How's that? I did think about putting, We'll see. Maybe a stripy one. Don't know whether this one will work, but I do definitely want some of that blue in there just to tie it all together. So I will just be really naughty and hack this piece. Oh, will it? Do you know what? I'm going to use that bit. That'll save me cutting into that. That was handy because, you know what? I'm not going to use the whole circle anyway. Half of it's going to get covered. Whoops. There is my doorbell. And I am the only one up. So if he rings the doorbell again, I'm going to have to go and answer it. But hopefully he just leaves my stuff and goes. Try another one? Yeah, I think so. Because my phone is still in bed. All right. And then I thought I could pop something like that. Though that needs to be brighter. Oh, I should have had yellow in that, not blue. All right. That's okay. We can hack another piece. Maybe I think it needs to have yellow in it to pull the yellow from that. That's okay. We can cut another one. Scissors. Hang on, he is ringing again. Hang on 2 seconds. Oh, getting my cardio, running. Apologies. Oh. The star paper looks lost in the background. Let me bring it up. Oh. So how's that? I don't think the stripes, I don't know, but those coloured stripes aren't going to work. It needs to have yellow in them. So I will bring some of that in. Oh. Excuse me. How's that for out of breath? Run. Run. I don't mind the stars. I think they're okay. Run. Right. Let's see, because the yellow might pop a little bit more now. Here we go. How's that? You know what? That's going to be fine. I'm just going to do that. Just for something different. Okay. I don't know. Maybe my brain's going, no, we don't think so. I don't know. It looks better, Deborah? I don't know. There we go. That's what I've got. Five? Should I do five in there? Or is that getting a little bit too much? What do you reckon? It's very busy. That's okay. Oh, it is definitely one of those days. It's definitely way too much. Okay. Oh, I love it. Too much. I'm actually thinking just the three, to tell you the truth. I am actually just thinking one, two, and three. with a little star popping around the back. That's what I'm actually just thinking. They may get used somewhere else, maybe. Yeah, I agree, Michelle. That's it. I'm just doing three now. Okay, so I'm happy with that. Now, I might put some, I haven't used a lot of ribbon lately. Maybe I will do some ribbon. We've got this, it's an iridescent, what is it called? Where's the names? Iridescent ribbon. So I'm thinking, now I'm all blurry. So I'm thinking I might put some of that behind there just to add a sparkle. And then I think I will go to my stash of Prada. I have to go through these. I'm getting all messed up as to what's current and what's not current. So I might bring them in as well. Oh, there we go. Oh, hello, Penny. Oh, you must have come in while I was racing to the front door. Normally my posties, I just leave my stuff in the driveway. But this one, some of them ring the doorbell, leave the products and then leave. But he was ringing the doorbell, ding dong, needed an answer from me. Okay. If I put another one on, I'd need to put two. Yeah, I know. I thought maybe the 1, 2, 3, 4 and the fifth element could be the mousse, but it doesn't work that way. So that's okay. I will do these guys. Now, I'm going to just flip that over so I know where I want to place it. And I'm just going to put adhesive not right to the edge so that way I can slip the star underneath and I can just flip you over and put you on like that. I'll come in so that way I can just slide that underneath like that. Thanks, Olivia. And then I think I might put this ribbon behind. It's very thick. Maybe I can, if I trim it, it'll fray. Maybe I can just do a loop. I'm not real good with ribbony stuff. Maybe I can just do a loop like that. Oops, wrong scissors. Just do a loop like that, and maybe I can fray the ends. Da 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 da. Get my other scissors out. Fray the ends on these a little bit. I do like the silver trim for fraying. Rather than this doesn't want to fray nicely on that side, and then you end up with fluff everywhere. So let's try and get this one to fray as well. One side wants to fray nicely, and then the other side just does not want to fray. Maybe I'm pulling it from the wrong side. Oh. Maybe that's what's happening. Anyway, that's not as neat as the other side. Let's just trim that off and leave it. It's got a little bit of fray. It'll be fine. I've got stuff everywhere. Stuff everywhere. Okay, Michelle said her postie left two parcels under the doormat and didn't ring the doorbell. Oh, my goodness. And you know what else is really annoying? Is when they put the parcel in front of the door so that you can't actually open your door when you go to, you can't open your door to go out and get it. Crazy. Had that happen a couple of times as well. So you have to go out the back door, round the front. Crazy. Crazy, crazy. Anyway, we used to have really good posties. But anyway, I shouldn't complain because he did stay and make sure that I answered the door and all that sort of stuff, so shouldn't really complain. Okay, so I'll pop him where I want him. Little something for you with lots of love from me. That's cute. Okay, and then we can slip that underneath. Just watch where you put your dimensionals. I didn't think about that. So that'll go there. Let's get some dimensionals on this guy. And we are almost done. Yippee! Oh, here we go. I've got some more. And then I've got a couple of others to show you as well. Now, I do also have, with orders this month, doing something a little bit different. With orders this month, if you spend $50 with me, I have got a card kit to send out to you. So this is the first one. And so you'll get all the pieces that you require. You just need to add your own stamps and just your sentiments. They don't need anything else, just your own stamps and inks. So I've got these cards. I have got a couple still already pre-packed, ready to go. So when you order $50 from me, you'll get the card kit and the instructions to go with them. And they are featuring the brand new Meandering Meadows Designer Series paper, which have been very popular to start with. And I am thinking, I've got a couple of kits left. I pre-made some, and I'm thinking I might need to actually get some more paper. So Penny says, this is the first time getting to watch me live. Yay, thank you. Always catch you on the replay. Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. I guess because we've had time changes as well, it makes a load of difference. Because I think we in the US and Australia are now a little bit closer together, and the UK people and Australia are a little bit further apart. I think that's what happens, because I know that during these summer months, I get to chat to my US friends a little bit more often and not so much my UK friends. But okay, so should I do green, or I might just do these clear ones actually. So I'm gonna stick one in there, a couple of smaller ones to go around the edges, and then I am calling in quits. So watch when you've got animals, watch where you put your bling. Just saying, animals or people, watch where you put your bling. So there we go. It ended up being a simple card. It didn't have to be as complicated as I was trying to make it. So there we have. I think that sentiment is really cute. A little something for you with lots of love from me. Aww, that's so cute. Does anybody make Christmas cakes and give them as gifts? I've made one Christmas cake, or was it a cake or was it a pudding? I can't remember. I don't eat them because I don't like dried fruit. But that would be a cool idea if you were doing little Christmas cakes and giving them away. You could use that one. Okay, so in the past, previously, I have made this card here, and I did him live that would be a good couple of weeks ago now. And then I have also made this guy. So he teams up. I think this stamp set teams up really, really nicely with this designer series paper. It's nice and bold and bright. And Wendy does. Wendy makes cards and cakes and gives them away. And then in the Stampin Blends and Beyond group, yesterday I went live and I actually coloured on a lemon lolly. So I need to make that one into a card now as well. I know this colour isn't in the kit, but in the design series paper, but I thought it would still go nicely with the yellow, the darker crushed curry in the paper. So that is him. I need to make him into a card. And so they're the samples I have so far. So what's going to happen is, and I forgot to do, see, it's been one of those days. If you are not on my newsletter list and would like to be on my newsletter list, here is my blog address, alisatilsner.com. You can sign up for my newsletter, and the card that we made today will go out as a typed up tutorial for the card that we made today. And it will have all the measurements and all the bits and pieces that we used, all the colours of the blends, so you don't have to think, what colours did she use? Because I didn't say them. So you can do that. You can head on over there and subscribe. And then I will have, like, in the newsletter, I'll also have links to, in, like, this one's got a video, so I'll have a link to that one. And then next Monday, I'll do a big blog post, and it'll have a roundup of all the cards that I've made this week using these, so that you can find them nice and easy. So that is that. Tomorrow will be that project. And then, of course, like I said, I've got the blends class. This one's dropped this morning. He's got a nice furry texture. So I've coloured this one in for the class. So it's just one image, because the same technique. I'm going to cover my bunny because my bunny is a disaster. My cat, I was okay. I was happy with him. Actually, I will show you my bunny. Have a look at him. Oh, my gosh. His eye, like, I thought, oh, this is working out really well. I coloured it with a base of black and then put black and white pencil over the top. And I started thinking, oh, this is working quite well. He's got a nice fuzzy, furry, hairy texture going to him. And then I did his face. So if we can't laugh at ourselves and our colouring and our mistakes and our boo-boos, there's something wrong. So maybe I will try him again. Maybe I will do a smoky slate background instead of a black, although I quite liked the black until I got his face. And then he's like, if I did that, it looks really cute. But his face, maybe not so much. So maybe I can make him faceless. Maybe I can put something over the top of him, because he does look cute like that. So then anyway, I knew I'd made a mess of him, so I just kept making a mess of him. Anyway, that class is available as well. I will put the link to that in the comments as well. So that's what you get. That's what you get. Some days, some mornings are really good. You've got all good intentions of having a really good day, and then it happens. It happens. But you know what? The day can only get better from here, or worse. Take it as it comes. Okay, thanks very much for joining me today. I will be back on Monday. I will be back in. I can't give a time because it's just like whenever I get the time, with another product spotlight, and that'll be covering the products that we'll be using next week. I'm not sure what that will be. Maybe it'll be the Meandering Meadows. Maybe I can look at that next week. And then, of course, next Thursday for my card making live. So have a great weekend, everyone. And if you're colouring, enjoy your colouring. Come and join the Blends and Beyond group, and come and share all your colouring in there as well. Okay, so thanks very much, and we'll catch you next week.